By taking Albert out of the touch without asking, I'm supposed to be taking care of him over spring break. Albert is the school guinea pig, so it's a very responsible job. Albert made him run for it. I'm beside myself because I know he will never be seen again. Me and I are racing around the kitchen table. Nemo is sleeping, and I am trying to flick his nose with a carrot. Lots of things get broken. Drop that cat, little late egg. Luckily for Nemo, Cricket and the cat comes in to take. To take my mind off the worry, losing a guinea pig off the worry. Of losing a guinea pig, we all go play outside, and it works because Uncle Ted kicks the ball so hard that it knocks me out. We have to drive to the emergency. Hang on to your hat. Moon at 50 miles an hour at least. Moon was fine, but they still gave him an X-ray and a little. Nemo loves it because he can show off and lie under a blanket and whimper. I say he should have fishes, but unfortunately, the nurse doesn't agree. When we get home, we find Granddad is missing. Uncle Ted phoned all the neighbors and is about to dial 911 when the stampede calls to say she has found Granddad in her living room watching really fast. She is pretty about it. Granddad says all the house looks the same when you get to my age, but I know it's really because the stampede has a bigger TV than you do. But you gotta be more. Uncle Ted says, how on earth did you end up here? I'm so worried sick about Albert, so I go into the yard to see if he's back in his hutch. I had left a care there to lure him, but it's still unnibbled. The next thing I know, Mob Ganger, the boy next door, pops over the wall. He says, do you want to pet my guinea pig? I think that's not your guinea pig. That's Albert. He says, that's not Albert. It's Belinda. I say, you better give him that. Robert Ganger, that's school property. And you'll be in big trouble with the police. Robert Ganger is so nervous, he lets Albert wiggle out of his hand. Albert scuttles through the house. Ah! Wait, Uncle Ted shouts, after him! We are madly chasing the guinea pig who charges through the fence. Nemo squeezes after him and gets stuck like a giant squeaking tomato. I say, lucky you are here, because you can rescue him in no time. Rescuing people from surface is normal for Uncle Ted. He doesn't look a bit worried. Uncle Ted says, hang on there. He raises up to call his friend at the fire station, but it takes him forever to find the boat. Chat. So anyway, I said, chat. And guess what he said? Chat. In the meantime, Mom comes back from the airport. She races back right into her bag for a new bottle of bubble bath and rubs it on Nemo's head. She wriggles him free in 2 minutes flat. Then she says, I'd like a nice relaxing cup of tea in the backyard. Guess what? The whole fire department shows up. Mom doesn't look surprised. She just glares at Uncle Ted. Nemo is already rescued. Uncle Ted says, don't blame me, blame my guinea pig. Over. The dad walking in. It turns out Uncle Ernie is feeling much better, but he doesn't think he will ever be able to look at a donut again. He says, make mine a double cheeseburger with fries and a banana shake to go. And as for Uncle Ted, he said, babysitting is the hardest job I ever done. I say, harder than fire grinding? Uncle Ted says, you better go be the baby. Albert is finally found 9.5 hours later. And Uncle Ted is very cool. Mom says, we can long like a house on fire. Oh, there's a bit of the map. Uncle Ted is teaching me cowboy technique. One more time. He lassoed the lamp. Mom said, I'd rather have everything in one piece. Thank you very much. I love my brother. He was too happy either. Okay. If you want to read this, you can find it from Good Camp. This is from my school. So, bye.